All rise. Who gives this woman to this man?
Her mother and I.
You may be seated. We are gathered here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, the joining of two hearts, and to give recognition to the worth and beauty of love, and to add our best wishes to the words that shall unite this couple in marriage. Today, we have come together to witness the joining of these two lives. For them, out of the routine, ordinary life, the extraordinary happened. They met each other. They fell in love and are today finalizing their relationship with their wedding. All of us here must feel grateful to be here to witness and to be a small part of your day. A good marriage must be created. It's not easy. I could stand here for a long time and give words of advice to you, but people here are not here to hear me speak. They're here to hear the vows that you are going to commit one to another. But I will tell you this, again, a marriage must be created. It is something that you have to create every single day. It's not easy. Those of us that are in this room that are married will tell you that marriage is hard. And every day, you need to get up and recommit yourself to make this marriage last. It will be hard. My words of advice is there's going to be days that you're going to wonder why you ever did this. It's simply the truth. But a love worth having, a marriage worth having, is worth the fight. And I'm going to encourage you to do that. Remember that you're never too old to hold hands. Remember to say, I love you every day. And again, it's not just marrying the right person, it's marrying the right partner. Now, again, we are here to hear the words that you have to say. And so I'm going to look at you, Lewis, and I'm going to say, do you take Haley to be your wife?
One second, actually. Let's come over here. Pour it. All right. Yeah, people are losing flowers. I lost mine.
Two flowers.
No, yeah, we gotta talk about this for a second. All right. Okay, all right.
Okay, now that we have that over, let's try this again. Lewis, do you take Haley to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish and protect her?
I do.
Forsaking all others and holding only unto her?
I do.
I would like you to take Haley's hands. And I want you to repeat after me. I take you, Haley, to be my wife.
I take you, Haley, to be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
My one true love.
My one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And I will love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And I will love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
Haley, do you take Lewis to be your husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, and cherish and protect him?
I do.
Forsaking all others and holding only unto him?
I do.
Haley, please repeat after me. I take you, Lewis, to be my husband.
I take you, Lewis, to be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And I will love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And I will love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
Louis, do you have a token to solidify this commitment that you now make?
I do. A ring.
I want to say a quick word about the ring. The ring represents authenticity. It is evidence of a love and a commitment. For many years, I taught history, and I was always fascinated how the ring played an important role in history. Before there were TVs and cell phones, computers, newspapers, how news was traveled was usually a word from the king to the different towns that he ruled over. And how that message was communicated was that it would be written down, the document would be sealed in wax, the king would take his ring and he would push it into the wax, and it would give that document authenticity that it truly came from the king. Now, this ring that you put on her hand and the ring that you are soon to put on his hand, okay, speaks of that authenticity. Speaks of it that it's real and it's true and it is, again, authentic. Louis, please repeat after me. Haley, this ring is my sacred gift.
Haley, this ring is my sacred gift.
With my promise that I will always love you.
With my promise that I will always love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
With all the days of my life.
With all the days of my life.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Haley, if you could grab your token and place it on Louis's wedding finger and repeat after me. Louis, this ring is my sacred gift.
Louis, this ring is my sacred gift.
With my promise that I will always love you.
With my promise that I will always love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
With all the days of my life.
With all the days of my life.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Louis and Haley, before your family and before these witnesses, you have both pledged to be joined in marriage. You have now sealed this pledge with your wedding rings. By the authority vested in me by the great state of Ohio, I now pronounce you husband and wife. No longer two, but one. Louis, you may kiss your lovely bride. And now, for the very first time, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Louis Wyam.
Hot.
Towards the back. Again, we thank you for your attendance here. Please grab a little bottle of water or for bubbles, and they are going to meet at the lobby on Jefferson and St. Clair to walk out. If we could meet them as a group down there with our bubbles and just send them off before the reception, they would greatly appreciate it, and thank you for your time.